just three phases are left for Lok Sabha elections 2019, and the country is moving towards May 23 when the results will be declared. Meanwhile, an Aam Aadmi Party MLA has joined the BJP. Union Minister Vijay Goel has claimed that not one but 14 AAP MLAs were in touch. To talk about these and many more issues, today I have with me Mr. RP Singh, a Delhi BJP MLA from Rajendra Nagar constituency. Mr. Singh, welcome to Monday Talk.
Thank you. My first
question is that an AAP MLA has joined the BJP. Your comments on this?
Well, people are frustrated with the Aam Aadmi Party. They are fed up of the Aam Aadmi Party. They feel suffocated within the party, and they have resentment against their leader. So they are joining us. There are people in queue who want to join BJP. They are looking for options. Some of them want to join us. Some want to look at more options also. And I have seen today's Al Kalama's tweet, which categorically state
exactly
that people are feeling suffocated and are being humiliated, and that's why they are joining.
So, Mr. Vijay Goel has claimed that not one but 14 MLAs were in touch with the Saffron Party.
No.
Your comments on this?
No. There can be probably more than 14. But people are suffocated. And people are openly rebellious against the Mr. Kejriwal there. And there are people who are on the record rebellious against Mr. Kejriwal. It's not one, there are many. Mm-hmm. And they are not able to and they are already daring the party to take action against them. And party can't afford to take action against them. I mean, that's the status of the Aam Aadmi Party. So it's not only one, there are many more.
But the Aam Aadmi Party is saying that BJP is indulging in horse trading. Your comments on that?
Horse trading is, are we going to form the government?
They are offering money.
No, that premise is totally wrong. Why shall we offer money to an MLA who wants to join on his own? I mean, would someone like to offer money to Al Kalama today? Mm-hmm. Or for that regard, Sandeep from Sultanpur Majra? Mm-hmm. The one guy from Shiravat from Outer Delhi? Mm-hmm. So, there are already people who are saying that we are openly rebellious against the functioning of Mr. Kejriwal. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, they need to manage their house well. Otherwise, if the people want to come and join us, why will we hold them?
Achha, there has been a demand since long, just recently, that Aam Aadmi Party has released its election manifesto, and they are again saying that they will this time make it sure that Delhi gets full statehood. So why they are stressing on getting a full statehood for Delhi?
It's a cover up for their failure. I mean, they miserably failed in last 4.5 years on delivery. I'll speak to you issue by issue. They said that will reduce the electricity bill by half. That's not true. Please go and talk to a common man. He said no, his electricity bill is probably more than what he used to come earlier. They said pani maaf, there is no water. If you want, I'll send you videos where people are categorizing that they are getting dirty, filthy, sewer water at their home. What was the next? Wi-Fi free. Please check your mobile. Do you have a Wi-Fi free?
I don't have.
So they said Wi-Fi free. And I remember once he went for the university election also, year previous to last year, he went for university election. He said, I'll give a ticket half the rate for the metro, for the student for the metro. Is that true? I travel my metro every day. I don't see that happening now. He said, I'll provide for security within the buses. I'll provide for guards within the buses. Is that true? No. I'll show that there are cameras in Delhi. Is that true? No. I'll provide for more buses. Is that true? No. We are still lacking of 7,000 more buses in Delhi. I mean, total fleet need to be 11,000 buses, and we don't have more than 3,000 buses still. And now recently they have probably ordered some 1,000 odd, I mean, after 4.5 years. So it's a failure, it's a failed government. They are trying to cover up their failures. And the best way is build up an issue which is a non-issue, and then try to deflect attention of the people. It is a non-issue. People of Delhi gave you mandate only on the issues which you spoke about, and you knew what sort of power you enjoy. But now you are saying no, I'll get this full statehood, and even if I give a opportunity to him that he will win all 7 seats, even I take like this. But will that change the nomenclature of the parliament? With the people in the parliament accept this proposition, especially Delhi would have got the statehood, but because of Mr. Kejriwal conduct is a setback to Delhi and the statehood issue of Delhi. The way he acted on the 26th January, some years back, as a chief minister, he squatted there and said, I will not move from here. But that led to a problem in Delhi. That tomorrow, he will say that, for example, some foreign dignitary is here. For example, President of America is here. And says, I won't allow America, President of America to be on the road. I'm the chief minister of Delhi. He can do it.
But Mr. Kejriwal and the Aam Aadmi Party is saying that they want full statehood because the government is not allowing them to carry out the development works.
Tell me which development work? From 32% to 42% for the finance has been enhanced for the from the budget. What development work has been installed? And let's talk about what development work they. I just gave you example of a lot of things. Have they planned for buses? We need 7,000 more buses. Where are those 7,000 buses?
When it comes to
tell me one new flyover which has been built by Mr. Kejriwal, one new flyover, or which has been initiated by him, deep side building up. Tell me one new underpass which has been done by Mr. Kejriwal. We don't need it's part of him. So if he is, tell me one new school. He claimed that he will build up 200 more schools. Any new school, any new college added up? No.
When it comes to funds also, he is saying that the government takes a lot of fund from Delhi but gives only some amount of money to the Delhi.
Delhi gets rather more funds than, because Delhi being a capital gets more funds than any other state in Delhi. Any state in India gets more provisions than any other state in Delhi. It depends how do you deal with people. Has he utilized all that funds which comes to him? Therefore, that's a bigger question. He talks about funds, but has he utilized whatever funds he has in Delhi? He has not done so. I'm asking a simple question. He said, I'll build up 200 new schools. Where are 200 new schools? He has renovated or he has done touch up to some schools or he has built up some more rooms in some schools, but doesn't help. I'll take you to constituencies. Simply put a poster that all those children who have got admissions, please reach out to them. There will be more than 1 lakh children who will reach out to you that they have not got admission in any school today. What happened to EWS children? Why shall those poor children suffer? I get every day 10 calls every day that my child has not been got admission because the Delhi government is not helping them. What to do about them? So he is not able to address the core issues of Delhi and he has not done it. So to cover up that, he is saying he is with his 7 MPs, he is not going to be Prime Minister of the country. He is not pitching for it also. Last time he pitched for to be Prime Minister of the country. He is not pitching for that. So how will the nomenclature of the parliament change with the 7 MPs also, which in any case are not winning? I mean, and I'm telling you a record, they will be on number 3 in Delhi this time. The way the people are angry with them, they might lose, some of their MPs might lose deposit, especially because I hail from Rajendra Nagar, their New Delhi candidate might lose their deposit also. That's the state of affairs.
That is bringing to my another question, that last time the BJP won all the 7 seats. What is the status this time?
100%. I mean, we are winning all 7 seats.
Any competitors?
See, for us, we are targeting for 50%+. And once we are 50+, then there is no competitor. When, if we get 51, 52, 54, 55, 56, up to 60%, then what is the fun? Whoever the competitor doesn't matter to us. But what I see today, that Aam Aadmi Party is badly losing. It will be routed out this time. They won 67 seats. They routed other parties, this time they will be routed out, their deposits will be foregone this time.
There is no alliance taking place in between the Congress and the AAP. It's clear now. So do you think that it will going to benefit the BJP?
I don't know, but my feedback from ground is different. There is some, although their candidates pitch against each other, but there is some tacit understanding which has happened. Tell me, can you please go and find out Brajesh Goel is a candidate from New Delhi. Can you see him there? No, he's not there. Can you please go and check on ground? Is Dilip Pandey working? No, he's not working. So there's some tacit understanding between the two.
Okay, the next year assembly elections are coming in Delhi. Who will be the CM candidate?
From BJP?
Yes.
Well, still time to come, we'll decide. Don't bother. Let the time come, we'll decide.
Okay. There are many celebs joining the BJP. That Gautam Gambhir, Sunny Deol. So is it that the party is counting more on the celebrities now compared to its leader for winning the voters?
See, when party grow, we are almost 11 crore cadre today.
Exactly.
Party is growing. Yes. And when party grows, you have lateral entry and you have people who grow from the hierarchy also. So we get lateral entries also. So Mr. Gautam Gambhir, Mr. Sunny Deol, For that regard, if I go by Mr. Manoj Tiwari, was also a lateral entry 5 years back.
Exactly.
He is the party president, is a popular face of in country. Hardeep Puri was a lateral entry, but he's a popular face among the six. So we get people who comes as lateral entry and people who go from the hierarchy also. So that's the growth process of the party.
Okay, my last question is, three biggest problems in Delhi and their solution.
The biggest problem in Delhi is health. Today, a common man doesn't get the poor man doesn't get the health facility, and it's because of Mr. Kejriwal. The easiest solution was that Modi care should have been implemented in Delhi also, where a poor man could have got 5 lakh rupees health insurance every year for each family. And that would have relieved people of so much of stress, and that would have built up new infrastructure in Delhi also as per hospital goals. That's the biggest issue. Second biggest issue is water today. People don't get potable drinking clean water. And that's doable. And once our government is there, we'll prove it to you that every household get 20 liter potable drinking water without any problem. Minimum, that's the minimum requirement for a family.
Exactly.
Third is education. Today, poor man can't afford for education. The amount which has to go to big schools, he can afford. There are no facilities in government schools. And government schools also slap door on the face by saying that you can't come to our school, you have to go to some other school, there are other schools, you have to go to other school, there are contribution. We'll ensure that basic education which is required goes to each and every poor in Delhi. And if need be, open more schools, open more shift of the school. The immediate to do is to open more shift. There are schools in Delhi, build up second shifts so that children can be accommodated. They don't suffer. And even all these big schools, they can also have shifts also. Delhi government should ask these schools to run shifts also. They can run a second shift also. They have infrastructure. Why to waste that infrastructure? So use this infrastructure for second shift of the schools. So this is the key core issues which is bothering Delhi. And the fourth and the major issue is Delhi is the pollution. Delhi government has failed in last 4 years to tackle this issue. We are living in a gas chamber. Every Delhiite is living in a gas chamber. And that's doable. It's not workable. I'll give one example for that. Delhi, if we work out, Delhi government think of, Delhi transport department thinks about and reach out to Delhi police that we want these 100 roads to be made one way so that there is no red light in that passage. 4 hours in the morning, one side one way, 4 hours in the evening, other side one way.
That's a good idea.
And that will help. That will reduce the pollution in Delhi. It's doable. Secondly, gradually start working, plan it out. It will take 2 to 3 years how to shift complete industrial city, okay. Not only polluting. Shift complete industry to the outskirts and decongest the main markets in city. For example, Chani Chowk, there are many, many markets in Chani Chowk.
Exactly.
Shift them to industrial areas and allow industrial area to convert into commercials. They can go up to 6 floors of the commercial level and ask, gradually shift this market to these commercial areas and shift industry on the outskirts. Give them infrastructure first to the industry, let them build there. This is part of the pollution. Once you do this, the decongestion, the city will go low, that will reduce pollution. The industry which is polluting and non-polluting also go to the outskirts. This will get more employment generation also in Delhi. And plus, also, when I said make Delhi one way, four hours in the evening, 4 in the morning, for 100 road at least, that will reduce pollution. That's doable.
We were talking about the education, so I have a related question. That how you see Mr. Manish Sisodia's work in the field of education in Delhi?
I'll appreciate. Put a RTI on Delhi Education Department and check on it, what I'm saying. They shifted some 250 crore rupees for some 54 schools in Delhi. The report by those 54 schools that whatever fund has been sent is not being properly used, the buildings are cracking, the funds which has been used has gone waste. That's not my report. I'll appreciate, dig into Google, you will get this some hint of it, or please go to file a RTI and you'll get it there.
Despite having such a busy schedule, you took out time for me. Thank you so much. You have come
Thank
up with
so
some
much.
Innovative ideas. Let's see how they will
no,
turn
no, if
out.
You want to discuss, come next time. I'll tell you how we can change the complete scenario on health, on education, on water, on electricity also. Given to me, we should make Delhi as a green electricity city. That every roof which is vacant has to put solar panel, and that should be linked to for electricity within that building and whatever square. the electricity company should take it back. And that will make city pollution free for next many years, and that will make electricity, we'll be self-reliant on electricity, on power for next many years, and it's doable. And if someone is not prepared to put panel on the roof, let government pay rent to that person and put a panel and say, "Jo khali hai, hamara hai; jo bhara hai, aapka hai."
So Singh, I can see that you have a lot of ideas. We will have another round of interviews someday.
Please, anytime.
We'll talk about it.
Very glad.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thanks so much.